You're watching Specials, and this week's episode tells the story of what it's like to cope after being rendered disabled despite being born fully functional. My name is Maia Chung.
Meet Patrick Rhoden. He was rendered disabled in 1995, 13 years ago, when he was shot by a man who alleged Patrick and his friends had stolen from him. Patrick's case was heard by the court, which ruled in his favor that his attacker, by way of reparation, should pay for the operation to make him walk again. At the time, it was several million dollars and had to be carried out in the United States. Patrick alleges that the man after the verdict hid his assets and never paid for the operation. Now, too much time has passed and he will never walk again, even if he was to get the operation now.
Disabled of a old went on and them end up disabled, you know. They're more angry, more than able-bodied, you know. Them get more angry, irritable, because being as them have to, most of them have to ask for do things, people for do things for them. Them kind of get hungry, keep on angering every day, you know, while them have to ask people for do things for them. But the mostly one when they get angry more, this is the one them who try to be independent, like do things to themselves, try to sort it out and make it happen to them. You understand me? Them not angry like me. Me not angry because if you notice, me can do almost everything like a able body. Only thing me can do is like a able body is walk.
Intolerance is a bad word against whoever it may be. Yeah. In India, it's extreme because the people with disabilities are basically self-inflicted, or the parents have inflicted on their children to make them good beggars. And this was the most horrific thing that I've ever seen.
Me design my wheelchair them for the most of my things, them like get height. Height, if me have something to paint, me going in a chair where me can go up higher, and chair design just for my house alone, I can spin right round in my house. You understand me? For my van, if me use going on my van, me going in a chair where small enough I can hold against my seat. And
so you design yeah. These chairs?
Yeah.
You yourself?
Yeah.
Them.
Yeah.
They ask me how I knew my true love was true. Someday you'll find all who love are blind. Oh, when your heart's on fire, you must stay alive. Smoke gets in your eyes. I chair them and I gaily laugh to think they could doubt my love. Yet today my love has
been as me used to play football and all them things, and they have the exposure, like I used to play for sand catching. And you know, you know say football it will carry you somewhere in life, because you get the praises are from people and all that, and your friend them and know say you can roll this game. You understand me? I look forward to say boy football I hit, you know, can carry me far away. You know, then a man come just gun you down like that and put you in a wheelchair. And then it's a baby stage start from now, because you don't know nothing about this wheelchair thing, and how to operate here and how to survive this, and you have medical to deal with and whole heap of things. One ton load of issue come down upon you, like you feel like say, boy, better you in dead.
Patrick now works with Food for the Poor, fixing wheelchairs, and has built up a successful business as a fixer and a seller of wheelchairs of all types. In April 2008, he recently, through the efforts of the Maia, Chung Autism and Disabilities Foundation, made a motorized wheelchair available through hire purchase and at a $20,000 discount to Peter Plummer, another man also wheelchair bound and in desperate need of a motorized chair. It wasn't a move he could afford.
Mother told me always to follow the golden rule. And she said it's really a sin to be mean and cruel. So remember, if you're untrue, angels up in heaven are looking at you.
Before I end up in a wheelchair, I have a friend where him get injured by a car. I drive, pull out a car from underneath a truck, and then a next vehicle come around right now. So I get him foot, then break up with him, have to use pin and pin it up. So two of my friends, we used to have him go around and sell cigarettes. I push him go around and I sell cigarettes. So, you know, and him Junior used to live in my community. And we used to push him and carry him around, and you know, we got all boat and got party and dance. Same way.
And you never left him out?
I never left him out. You understand me? So him got foreign and him say, Patrick, when he first time he got foreign, he come back with pin in his foot. And say him soon here before walk. So me always a prayer say June have a year before walking, and him go up back and come back and start walk with the walker, the four walker stick something. So me I say, yes, Junior. You know? So me and him same way rap. We got all about CMA till him go back and come back with one stick, one of the walking stick. Yeah, start up. Yeah, start walk with that. And I say, yes, Junior, you're fully loaded there now. Next time Junior go far and come back, Junior come without his stick and start play a ball. Well, when I say what the disabled community really need right now is them need some people out there who really not give up in life and motivate the others. Because through them not see nobody and do nothing and not motivate and not do anything towards the community. Them kinda give up. And me, I beg them, please really as a youth out on the street then. We know say it's very hard still, but when you give up it's harder. And you love life. No care what happens. Once you have life, there is hope. And if you go give up, it's very hard. And you can't get back when you give up. And when I had a situation, maybe in a long time ago, well, things are much better when you give up and you can't even fight back. When you get a little, when you get somebody to motivate you. But now, when you give up in life and somebody to motivate you and MC say you're going way down, it's hard for you to get back. You need things in place for disabled. You have even the monorail where bring a next life to disabled. Not functioning properly right now. Not functioning, them short a whole heap of equipment, this, that. Them are tell you, them are turn away. And all them things because them not have the proper equipment and the proper place to deal with it. The youth them up a Mona where I do the basketball, the road race and all them things. They went and them do all them sport, them not get nothing. Them need some attention more to get them to do the sport. Like them like the sport. You understand me? Them want to do the sport, you know, but if them for look about some food and them not have proper things to get, proper job, proper nothing for them get the food, them can't go sport. They have to leave the sport alone. They have to go on food, because food is the most important thing to them to keep them alive. But as long as them can get proper support, then when I do the sport, man, you hear more about wheelchair, basketball, tennis, all of them things there. You don't hear about it. Because it just go down. Instead of going up, it just go down. All of them things there, them frustrated. Now, they want to see proper things in place now, implemented. Some things for disabled guys. Yes, yeah, Yes, the ministry, they want to see the youth, them in a the disabled people them now. You know, ministry of health, them want, you know, more time, some people out there need even a wheelchair. Them can't get it through the ministry of health, the organization, them can't get the things them for the youth, them. That's why, you know, so many organizations have fallen out now. And no money now run. You understand me, but we don't know.
Has your sex life been severely impacted?
Well, only problem I have with my sex life is more the lady have to help herself.
What visions made for addressing issues like protection for your community? People who cannot walk, who are wheelchair bound, who are affected by disabilities. Since you have become disabled, have you noticed that any of the campaigns that are out and about target people who are disabled sexually? Like for HIV and other STDs?
No, not of me, no. Not going on. I don't see that.
How do you feel about that?
But it's bad for disabled because I don't know if it's in the budget that's the more said this that about disabled, but I don't see anything going on right now for disabled. So we don't know if them have anything to say about it down in the coming year here. Right now, being as the change of government just come in or what, but
you know,
I feel like it should, things should have in place right now for disabled to help out each other. Even the ramps, them were been here, did a bill for disabled, and a couple of them start build. Being as the election come up now, all of them think they're not implemented anymore. But I don't know if the changes have a make back, because it was implemented already. Mm-hmm. So I feel like it should carry on the same way.
Ooh, if you see me walking down the street and I start to cry each time we meet, walk on by, walk on by. See the tears, just let me grieve in private, cause each time I see you, I break down and cry. Walk on by, walk on by, walk on by. Broken into, walk on by, walk on by. Foolish pride, that's all that I have left. Don't let me hide the tears and the sadness you gave me when you said goodbye. Walk on by. Walk on by.
all that I have left. So let me hide the tears and the sadness you gave me when you said goodbye. Walk on by, baby. Walk on by. And I really gotta go, so keep on walking. I might change my mind if we start talking.